We got a surprise update in creative today. This morning I woke up to check out the brand new hub, which is awesome, by the way. You guys can go check it out in that video. But to my surprise, there was a brand new update in creative mode. We got a ton of new prefabs, we got a ton of new galleries, and we're gonna check out everything today, and then we're gonna build something cool out of it. So let's just jump in and check it out. Okay guys, I always like to start by looking at the prefabs that they've given us. So if you go to prefabs and check out recently added, you're gonna see all of the Wailing Wood stuff that they added a couple of weeks ago. But now they've added a bunch of these wood shanty stilted houses things. So let's look at all of them. So this is the stilted shanty wood houses. This looks so cool. This kind of reminds me of the Fortilla prefabs, but all of these pieces are just like really awesome, like broken down wooded pieces. Honestly, these would have been nice to have at the end of September so that we could have built a bunch of our haunted stuff using these pieces. Like, these pieces are perfect for like spooky kind of maps. I really like this prefab, which kind of shows off like the different color roofs, and like the burnt type wood is really cool. This is the wood shanty sinking houses. So this would be like right above like a swampy area. I really love these like wood plankings. I think that will add a nice touch to some maps. This is called the wood shanty hut, which is cool. I love this new fireplace here. That's awesome. This is called the stilted house, which is also really cool. Pretty basic house though. This is the wood shanty outpost. Like, I really love this if you're building like Hicksville, like just perfect for that. And then this is called the dock shed. I really love like the different colors we have here with the blue and the yellow and the red. One thing I love about the prefabs is they really show you how to use different pieces, how to like combine colors and that kind of thing. So this is really helpful to me to like see these kind of things. Okay, so those are all the prefabs, guys. Now let's check out the galleries that they gave us. Okay, so this is the floor and stair gallery. Now I think this really shows off really well the different types of wood that they've given us here. Like right here we have the non-burnt wood, and this is the burnt wood. I love the addition of the burnt wood so you can have like burnt down houses or slightly burnt down like areas. I think it'll add a nice touch to different maps. And then these new stairs are so cool and will add such a nice touch to creepy maps, as well as these different pieces too. Really good for like, I don't know, treehouse type things. Like if you're gonna build an Ewok village or something, that would be really cool to add in. And then we have two new wall galleries as well. I really like these new pieces they've added for us here. These pillars right here are gonna be really useful in building maps. And then they have so many different varieties. We got blue, we got like this darker brown, the light brown. There's green and red and yellow, and all of the walls come in those different shapes too. And then there's just more colors over here, right? We've got so many colors. Once again, we've got the burnt colors here, and then just more variety here. Blue, red, green, yellow. Oh man, I love the options this is opening up for us. Same story here, we've got three new roof galleries. So it's all of these like roofs, but in their different variants, with different colors, like the different broken down types, different angles, that kind of thing. And then just all the different varieties here. So we've got this roof here, this roof has wood on it. These roofs have holes in it. Like, this is just super cool and very useful pieces for building maps. Okay, let's check out the prop gallery, guys. So I'm not seeing anything like crazy new in here. We do have some of these like chimneys, which is really cool. Oh, this is cool. These different ropes are awesome. Let's see, can we run on it? We can run on this one, that's awesome. Okay, we can jump on this pole. Can we run on this? Oh, you can't run on that. I wonder, can we run on the clothes? I like this clothesline. Oh yeah, you can run on the clothes. So here, I just made this as big as it can go. The clothes do wave, which could be interesting for something. I don't really know how I'd use this, but it's an interesting piece. I'm sure you guys can come up with something awesome. Anyways, guys, I'll let you guys search through that. There's some cool things in there. We got some swamp trees, some new rocks. That's really cool. Most of these things have collision on them, so you can jump on them. These little rocks do not have collision, so you can just fall right through them. And they have the like invisible thing on the backside going for it as well. And then we've got new terrain, guys. We got all this new like grass color, which is cool. I love having different options for grass. And then we've got these new terrain pieces. I think these are glitched right now, guys, because we've got like the swampy pieces here, but then they have like desert pieces. And when you go into the gallery here, it looks like they should all be swampy. So I'm sure that'll be fixed momentarily. But once again, guys, I really like this texture on these. Like, you even look at these rocks. Like, I love this like dark rock. And I think that'll be a nice way to add different types of terrain into your maps that are darker, as opposed to like the lighter colors that we have in our current galleries. So this is a pretty significant update, guys. I like this. There's lots of really cool stuff to work with here. So what are we gonna build out of this? I kind of have this vision of like a swamp turtle monster thing house. I don't know if that makes any sense. Let's just build it real fast. So I started with the shell and I used the burnt wood as the shell piece. And then it was the face. The face just worked perfect with the pieces. I really didn't even have to do much here except for assemble it. Then it was the undercarriage and the booty of the beast. And then it was moving on to the legs. The legs were actually didn't quite turn out like I wanted to, but it ended up being okay, I think. And then we moved on to the details on top. I put like the chimney and the clothesline to make it look like people lived on him. And then it was just bushes and foliage and overgrowth to make it look like he was really old and overgrown. And then added some texture to the face. And then the surrounding terrain was pretty easy just with the water, the tepid water and trees. And we had our turtle beast. So there you guys have it, brand new up today. It's really cool. I'm excited to see what you guys build with it. Send me pictures of what you guys build on Twitter. I want to see it. All right, guys, good luck and have an awesome day.